If you don't allow me to go to the next slide, I cannot that's the only difference. So in that sense, the lowest four trial values are infinite volume extrapolated from the base measure. Here we just take the largest volume and we find.
Okay, so
it shows that there is a little bit of
we know.
Nothing to me, as you can see.
Not very much.
Yeah, not very much.
But the interjection for
the the problem is that those two are strongly correlated, and also the objects A from B will now heavily rely on the standard perturbation theory results, where some of the coupled dependence in B is absorbed in those C and CB CF coefficients. And yes, our determination of B is very weak. Yes, the arrows are large. Meaning down F is really not easy, and this is part of the ambiguity that we cannot make a definitive statement yet about the precise location of the low-lying scalar in F unit. Yes. So now I'll be doing here, so that is your two-side crash course on closed collective work and also steel. So we do we apply living order depends on the terminology. Then we instead of power perturbation theory for the pilots, but we feed in the goldstones as we derive them from the experiment. So that's what we do. This is a perfectly necessary and consistent way of doing the analysis. I will spare you from the I will show you the Bolson spectra. So that is the spectrum at 3.20, that's at 3.25, and that's at 3.20. So what you see here is one. It's very non-QCD-like. It's not a parallel spectrum. They are collapsing to a single gap in the cover limit. That gap is shrinking as you go to the lattice spacing, and the cell out itself is collapsing. So by the time you reach at 3.0 and you are down in that region, you barely see any significant is breaking in the Gaussian spectrum. I'm sorry. That's my fault. That should be, this is how it is not showing that I wrote. I'll pick up the other one. Yeah. The new one symmetry, the exact new one symmetry. Yes.
And the other
this is the solution in the parameters of Benjong and Slipsharp, the solution to the Gaussian spectrum. The C coefficients seem to be comparably equal with the narrow bands, and we are just using one gap. This one is done. I misplaced that plot for 3.25, and we don't have analysis yet at 3.30. If you look at this range where our US data is, on that scale, you can see the scales, even smaller here, they are almost completely collapsed. This is the various goldstones.
Thank you.